Medical marijuana, $1 billion in construction projects. It's been a busy week at the Capitol.
Yes, it has. Lawmakers worked until late last night to get all of this done. And now the 2014 legislative session is officially in the books. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Kate Renner is joining us now. And history made this year.
Yeah, it was a decade of attempts for legislators. And just last night, the Senate and House passed the historic medical marijuana bill with large bipartisan support. The medical marijuana bill is now headed to the governor's desk for his signature. This bill that passed was a scaled-down version of an original bill circulating the Senate. It prohibits the smoking of marijuana, and patients with PTSD or chronic pain are not given access. Doctors can begin writing prescriptions for medical marijuana starting in July of next year. The other big projects to pass was the billion-dollar bonding bill full of building projects around the state, a budget bill that increases spending on education, public safety, and broadband development. But even after all their success, Democrats and Republicans still see the outcome of this session differently.
I think that we did get a tremendous amount accomplished this year with the minimum wage increase, with the safe schools passage, additional tax cuts for Minnesotans, property tax cuts we're going to pass today, and a really, really good bonding bill.
As a result of this session, we have one of the highest tax increases in state history. We have the highest spending increase in state history. At a time when Minnesota's economy was recovering, it was frankly unnecessary.
Representative Kurt Dowd was talking about the $2 billion of tax increases from last year that preceded this year's $550 million tax cut. Now, we should expect to see many more of these debates along the campaign trail. All 134 members of the House are up for re-election this year, so they're going to be talking about what they did in the House.
Or didn't do.
Or yes. Didn't do.
Yep. All right. So what about the governor? Have we heard from him with everything done now?
Yeah, overnight we got a statement from Governor Dayton. He called this a progressive session. He praised the $550 million tax cuts as well as the $1 billion committed to infrastructure projects. And he also will be up for re-election this fall, so he'll be talking about this session a lot as well.
Lots of people will. Thank you, Kate. Well, one of the